Hi all, welcome to GreyTip Online Training Webinar. I'm Shweta, your host for the day, and our today's topic is No PF, the E-Way. But before starting today's webinar, I would just like to quickly remind you of our upcoming expert talk on Form 16, 10 Things You Should Know. This will be facilitated by CA Malai Damania, who is a known personality in CA world. I request all of you to register for the same. You can register by visiting our website www.greytip.in. Under resources you will find the webinar, and from there you can register for our upcoming webinars. For today's webinar, I request all of you to quickly intimate me if there is any problem in you watching our webinar. We'll take your questions towards the end of this session, so I have unmuted all of you. At the end, I'll take your questions and we will be more than happy to answer your questions. Moving ahead, we'll quickly go through our workshop objectives. So by the end of this workshop, we all will be able to understand the concept of provident fund. Then we'll go through the deductions as per the laws, understand what are the returns if you invest in a PF, and what are the tax benefits an employee can avail on the same. Then we'll go through the firms associated with Provident Fund or PF. Next would be using EPFO website for generating challans, online payments and submission. We'll also teach you to use the application GreyTip Online for updating PF details and generating your ECR, which makes your work easy. And last but not the least, how to generate statutory reports. My first question would be, why Employee Provident Fund? It's as simple as government has made a provision that if you need to save amount of your salary, so then they have given you a provision of Employee Provident Fund where you can invest for a certain period of time, or say till your employment period. Then you get returns on that which are tax-free to an extent from government side. And then you have a lump sum of amount which you can use for your future investment plannings. Now, PF deduction for employees. As we all are aware that all the employees or people working in a company whose basic or basic plus DA is equal to or more than 6,500 are eligible for PF deduction. Now it is to be taken into note that if a person's basic is more than 6,500, then it is up to him whether to opt for PF or not. But a person who is earning PF of 6,500 or less than that, then it is mandatory. Now, the deduction will be 12% of the basic plus DA or basic of an employee. If the basic plus DA is more than 6,500, then an employer have an option that rather than paying 12% of the actual amount, he can pay only rupees 780, which is 12% of the ground rule or basic criteria 6,500. Now, PF deductions for employers. All the organization who are having an employee strength of 20 or more than 20 are eligible for PF deductions. So, if your company has got an employee strength of 20, then you need to register yourself under EPFO. Now, we have seen in the earlier slide that employer has to contribute the equal amount, that is 12%. Apart from that, he has to pay 1.61% towards the admin charges. So I have bifurcated the amount for you, that how the employer's 13.6% is taken into account. 8.33% goes into pension fund, then 3.67% goes to the provident fund. The same bifurcation will be done for all the employees for whom employer is paying the contribution. Now, apart from this, employer will also pay certain fees to EPFO like EDLI, which is Employee Deposit Linked Insurance. Fees would be 0.5%. Then admin charges for PF scheme, which would be 1.10%. And admin charges for EDLI scheme, which would be 0.01%. Now we will understand this with an example. Suppose an employee's basic is 5,000 rupees. So we take his PF contribution as 12% of his basic, which would be rupees 600. Now if we divide employer's contribution on the same, so towards pension fund, employer would pay 8.33% of 600, that is rupees 4.417, and provident fund 3.67%, which would be rupees 184. And he would need to pay admin charges of 1.61% on rupees 600, which would be rupees 81. So in this way, a consolidated report will be prepared for all the employees working in the organization, and employer will pay the amount to the EPFO every month. Now talking about tax benefits and returns, whatever amount gets paid to PF, paid towards PF from an employee's salary, comes under exemption in under section 80C. So say if a person is making really huge amount of salary per month and his annual investment towards PF goes to say more than 1 lakh, then only up to 1 lakh he can take tax exemption under section 80C. Now there is one more benefit which is called as section 1010C. When a person opts to withdraw his money from PF, at that time he will get a tax exemption on the withdrawn PF amount under section 1010C. It will not consider his income, provided that your PF account was active for less than 10 years. If a person's account of PF is active for more than 10 years, then, and if he wants to withdraw later, then this will be considered as his pension and which will be taxable. Now returns. The current rate of interest on PF is 8.5%. Now we will go through the forms which are to be filled by the employees. So first is the form 2. It's a nomination form which every employee fills at the time of joining an organization. Then there will be form 19. If a person has resigned, then he will together fill form 19 and 10C. 19 is PF withdrawal and 10C pension withdrawal. Both can be filled only after resignation. Then there is form 10D. Now which it is about what I was talking in the last slide, that if an employee has completed 10 years of service or he has attained 58 years age, then his amount will be paid only as a pension. Form 20, if any of the PF scheme member has died, then his PF amount can be claimed through form 20. Form 13, suppose an employee has left one organization and he has joined another. If he doesn't want to open a new PF account in the new company, then he just needs to fill form 13 and his PF account would be transferred from the last company to this company. And there is form 31. This is for withdrawing advance from PF account. If an employee wants money for say marriage or for house construction or for any of the reasons, then he can fill this form and take up advance out of his PF account. Now we will go through all the forms mandate for the employers. So there is form 5. Due date for form 5 is 25th of every month. When it is required, every time when an employee joins your organization and he has to be included under PF scheme. Then there is form 10. Again the date is same, 25th of every month. In this you have to fill the details of all the employees who have resigned in that particular month. Coming down to next form, this is form 12A. Date remains the same, 25th of every month. It contains consolidated details of the particular month. Say if you will be filling it for November, So this form will contain all the new joinees, left employees and employer employee PF contribution. That means all the transactions related to PF for this particular month. Then there is form 3A, for which the due date is 30th April. You need to fill it only once in a year, and it states all the employee contribution details. Then there is form 6A. Again, the date is 30th April. Here you will get the employees consolidated contribution list. This will be for all the employees working in your organization. Then again, there is one form 5A. This is required only once in a total lifetime when your organization registers at Employee Provident Fund Organization India. At that time, you need to fill this form. Now we'll start that how we can make use of EPF website and reduce our cost of going to office, then saving our time of going to bank, then filling in your challan and receipts and all those things. So we'll quickly start with our EPFO login. So first we'll go through how to register or login on EPF website. As you can see in the screenshot, this is how the page looks. If you have already registered, you simply put your username and password and click on sign in and you will log in. I have mentioned the link also over here or the website address where you can go and log in. In case you have not registered to EPFO online so far, just go and click on register. Next, you would be asked to select the state where your establishment is covered. I have selected it as Karnataka, and then out you, as you can see, just down to it, there is an option, select your EPFO office. So in Karnataka, there are these many offices. You have to select your EPFO office. Now, depending on your location, in which state you are, you have to select your state here, and according to that, you will get the EPFO offices over here. Once done, you will be redirected to this page. Here you need to put your establishment code. So once you put it here, just click on get details, and whatever you have been doing manually with your establishment code, all the details will appear here, like the name of your organization or establishment name, address registered with EPFO, and date of coverage from which you have opted for EPFO scheme. Now you have to put the PAN number, which will be definitely your company's PAN number, whatever the name on PAN, and then you have to put name of first, second, third person, their mobile number and emails. Once you are done with this, next step would be to fill in these characters in this box and click on get PIN. Once you click on get PIN, so you will get an authorization PIN on your registered first mobile number. What you have to do next, click on I agree, put that PIN here and click on register. Once you do that, you will be registered to EPFO online and you can just start doing your work. Now what is the process of filing PF online? First is log in to the link which I have mentioned, so it will redirect you to the same page which we saw. Upload the ECR file. Once you upload ECR file, a summary page of uploaded ECR file will appear. You have to fill in the details regarding EDLI, EPF, all the charges. On click of your submit button, a digitally signed PDF file will appear. Now, next, what you will do, once you approve the PDF file, that all the details entered by you are correct, then a challan will be generated with a TRRN, which is temporary return reference number, along with an acknowledgement slip for the uploaded ECR file. Print this challan and make the remittance. Now there are two ways by which you can remit or pay PF. First, if you are a corporate internet banking customer of SBI, you can just make online remittance or payment using the TRRN number which you have just generated. Second, you have already taken the printout of this challan, make a DD or a check and deposit to any of the nearest SBI branches. Now again, the challan which you have generated, it will be valid only for 15 days. In case you haven't filed your PF in these many days, you haven't paid the amount, then you need to generate it again. How to fill ECR? Step 1. Use any spreadsheet. You can use Excel or OpenOffice. Create all the member details as per the prescribed format and save the file in CSV format. I'll show you the sample. This is how the file looks. Here you will have all the details, employees, PF account number, their employee code, name and all the details related to this person. Next, when you are done with updating all the details in this file, then you have to save it in the CSV format. Now open the CSV file in any text editor, say Notepad, which is very common. And now you have to replace all the commas with hash this sign. Now save the CSV file. Change the file extension while saving from CSV to text. Your file will be ready for upload. Once you save it to text file, you can upload it simply to your online EPF account. Guess not so easy. Quite complicated. First work in spreadsheet or work office, and then you go change all the formats and then save it to text. I'll give you a solution. So here where our Gratip online application enters, use remains same. Enter your username and password and click on sign in. Now first what we will do, we will update the PF info of all the employees in application. This will be the step 1. So where you can get it, under employee in the left hand side, just click on that. Click on employee information. Here in PF, you can update PF information of all the employees. Click on edit. Just click here that employee is included in PF scheme. What is the date of joining? Here you have to select the scheme type, then PF number. And next, when you are done with adding all these details, then click on save. This is the first step. Now, that's what all you have to do. No working into work or office or Excel file or anything and then saving it, changing all the formats and all. That is the only thing that you need to do with our Gratip online application. Once you have done that, now we'll show you how to generate this ECR file. Go to reports. Once you are done with updating the PF details for all the employees, now go to reports gallery. Once you reach here, under reports you will find statutory reports monthly. Under this, click on PF ECR format. Now once you click on this, you will get this small window which will ask you what you want to do for ECR format, whether you want to run it or you want to generate. So run is the option. If you click on run, you can see this sample file where you can check all the details. We would always recommend that before generating ECR for any of the month, just once run it and just cross verify all the details which you all have put in. Once you have verified, then now you can generate this ECR. Go to reports, reports gallery, statutory reports monthly and PF ECR format. Now you can just click on generate ECR file and you will get a text file. This is how it looks. This is just a sample file. Here you can see employee number, then their PF number, all these details will display here. So this will be the whole process on how you will be generating the ECR file. Once you generate this file, just upload it into the EPFO website, cross verify it there, submit it as we have seen the last procedure. Once you submit, then generate the challan from there. Then you will have the two options. With that TRRN number, you can pay it to the SBI bank through online payment only if you are a corporate customer, or you can make a DD or a account pay check towards SBI and get it remitted to any of the branches of SBI which is nearest to you. This brings us to today's end of session. I hope the session was informative for you. So many questions, but time is a constant over here. We will get disconnected, say, in few seconds. Thank you all for attending this session. Still, you can mark all your queries whose queries are not been answered to webinar@greatip.com, or you can personally write to me at shwetaalok@greatip.com. This would be shwetaalok@greatip.com. We would be more than happy to answer your queries. You can write us on any of the emails. Have a great evening, everyone. Bye-bye.